So we can wait for 5-10 seconds.
Yes, I welcome all my field colleagues as well as HO colleagues and their family members. So today is a motivational webinar on staying positive in the COVID era, and that will be taken by our guest of honor, who is none other than Dr. Parveen Bhatia, well-known surgeon from Delhi, and he is a great motivator. At the same time, he is a very good person by heart and an excellent professional. Among the panelists, we are having the patron who has grown from the level of FSO till the level of DGM. That is none other than Mr. CP Goyal with us. Thank you, Goyal sir, for joining us. Are having none other than our HR head, Mr. Sachin Kapoor. Welcome, Sachin ji.
Thank you, sir.
Along with us, we are having all our senior managers, that is the ZSMs from across India. Welcome all the zonal managers. And then we have all the three marketing managers with us. So you can see on this Sunday evening, we are having the entire HO, the field is there, so that we can have a motivational lecture and we can have a motivation within us. And any one of you, if having any question, then you can post the question to your respective ZSN on the WhatsApp. So that will be addressed by the Dr. Saab, right? And if you see, we all are having a common background in which we have written our vision of 1,000 crores, because many of our family members would be looking that where this company is going. So we are going towards the 1,000 crores, and your husband or your wife or your son or daughter has a great contribution where we are, and for this 1,000 crore definitely they will be adding the value. For this, ek mujhe sher yaad aata hai, jab hausla bana liya uchi udaan ka, jab hausla bana liya uchi udaan ka, phir dekhna fizool hai kad aasman ka. So, and at the same time, at the background, you might be seeing that we have to take the initiative for at all the four levels, whether the doctor, patient, retailer, and the stockist. Now, in this era, आपके दिमाग में काफी लोगों के मन में टेंशन होगा कि मेरा हस्बैंड, मेरी वाइफ या मेरा बेटा, मेरी बेटी जा रहे हैं फील्ड में तो क्या होगा, या yourself might be having a lot of apprehensions. So for that only Dr. Saab is there, who is clinically very sound, he is having the experience, so he can share his experience medically also. मैं अभी इससे पहले कि गोयल साहब को दूं एक लास्ट शेयर बोलना चाहूंगा, अपने हौसले को ये मत बताओ, अपने हौसले को ये मत बताओ कि तुम्हारी तकलीफ कितनी बड़ी है, अपने हौसले को ये मत बताओ कि तुम्हारी तकलीफ कितनी बड़ी है, अपनी तकलीफ को ये बताओ कि तुम्हारा हौसला कितना बड़ा है. इसलिए तकलीफें तो आती रहेंगी, जब तक हमारा जीवन है तकलीफें रहेंगी, वो जीवन हो ही नहीं सकता जिसमें तकलीफें ना हो, पर अपना हौसला तकलीफों से बड़ा होना चाहिए. विद दैट आई वेलकम यू ऑल, एंड विद दिस आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट मिस्टर गोयल टू ब्रीफ, टू गिव अ इंट्रोडक्शन टू द एंटायर फील्ड फोर्स, क्योंकि ऐसे मौके बहुत कम मिलते हैं.
थैंक यू मिस्टर नारंग. माय डियर वाल्टर बुक्सा लाइट्स, डॉक्टर, रेस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर भाटिया सर एंड ऑल माय कलीग्स एंड देयर फैमिलीज, आई एम चंद्र प्रकाश गोयल फ्रॉम कलकत्ता. आई एम जस्ट 40 इयर्स ओल्ड इन दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. आई जॉइंड इन 1980 एज अ मेडिकल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव, एंड टुडे आई हैव रीच्ड एट द एज ऑफ 40 इयर्स. आई एम स्टिल सर्विंग, दो आई हैव रिटायर्ड 5 इयर्स बैक. But our owners are so good. They say, no, जब तक है जान तुम्हें यही रहना है, यही काम करना है. So this is the environment which we get in our organization, like a family culture. So I express my gratitude to Madam President and our young director, Mr. Nishant Baldia ji. उनका कहना है कि tough times do not last long, but tough people do. Never quit. What come may, you should never quit and always stay positive. So main zyada bolunga nahi. I am dying to hear Dr. Saab on this COVID era. Jo ki 1918 mein ek bar Spanish flu aaya tha, Dr. Saab, Spanish influenza 1918 mein tab bhi yehi situation aayi thi, and everybody has come up. So पॉजिटिव वे से कैसे लेना है ये आज हम डॉक्टर साहब से सीखेंगे. आई हैंड ओवर, थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई हैंड ओवर टू मिस्टर सचिन.
गुड मॉर्निंग एंड गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. I would like to welcome you all to this first webinar motivational session by our sir Dr. Praveen Bhatia. And friends, let me tell you, in this critical era, we all are there with you and with your family members. We are there and we will be serving you 24/7. God forbids if any help or any support is required from our back-end team sitting at HO. We all are there to support you. I would also like to welcome all our senior leaders who are sitting here, all our ZSMs. Mr. Vinod, ZSM Mumbai. Mr. Ajay Chopra, ZSM Punjab. Mr. Vijay Pratap, ZSM. Mr. Vijay Pratap, ZSM Delhi. Mr. Milind, ZSM Nagpur. Mr. Partha Sarthi, ZSM Chennai. Mr. Narsimha, ZSM Hyderabad. Mr. Durgesh Pratap, ZSM Lucknow. Mr. Shabal Roy, ZSM Kolkata. And Mr. Ashutosh, ZSM Patna. Without wasting much of our time, I would like to hand over the next session to Ms. Subhoi Hali.
Thank you, Mr. Sachin. Well, Dr. Bhatia is a very, very well-known name in the industry and otherwise. So, but just to know him better, that what kind of a multifaceted personality he is, I would quickly run through the profile of Dr. Praveen Bhatia. We all know that Sir is a well-renowned surgeon. He is a robotic bariatric surgeon at Sir Gangaram Hospital and also at Bhatia Global Hospital and Endosurgery Institute. Since I told you earlier also that he is a multifaceted man, Sir is extremely passionate about sports. As you can see in the pictures, you can see he loves skydiving, paragliding, mountain climbing. And Dr. Bhatia is also penchant for jungle safari and wildlife photography also. Dr. Bhatia is an ardent speaker and is an excellent orator. He has done innumerable motivational speaker programs, not only for schools, but colleges and also parents for all across the country. And recently in these COVID times, he has done a FAQ session with Tax Law Educare Society also. So in spite of his busy schedule, he is taking out time for all these co-curricular activities as well. And Sir is a health enthusiast to the core. You can see his video here that how beautifully he is doing the jumping jacks.
Wow. Great.
So age is just a number. I mean, by looking at this video, we can definitely say this. And if I talk about more about Sir, he's a health fanatic to the core. He's always on the fitness trail. As there, this is a small dumbbell session that you can see that the Sir is doing. In spite of his busy schedule, he takes out time for this. And I also remember from one of his previous sessions, a very famous quote that he always tells all of us, that sar jaye but sair na jaye. So that's how he is. That says it all about his fitness personality also. He's a fitness enthusiast. And yes, professionally speaking, he is a leading laparoscopic surgeon who specializes in the minimal access surgery and has more than 36 years of experience. You can see the photographs of Sir performing the laparoscopic surgery and the robotic surgery. So that's all about Dr. Bhatia. Now, without wasting any time, I would hand over the session to Sir. Sir, floor is all yours.
Thank you. Thank you very much. At the outset, you cannot imagine how happy I am to have such kind of Zoom session with all the top-notches leaders of Walter Bushnell. And it gives me pleasure to interact with you all on this Sunday evening. And I must give the compliments to Nishant Barlia and Madam Barlia for having such a wonderful, excellent team. Today, I have been introduced to the team, and it is a fantastic moment for me. I bring greetings from my terrace garden, which you have just seen in the intro by Subhai. And definitely, I would put this way that one has to remain positive, staying positive in this COVID era. And I bring greetings from Institute of Minimal Access, Metabolic and Bariatric Surgery and Institute of Robotic Surgery, Sir Gangaram Hospital, as well as greetings from Bhatia Global Hospital and Endo Surgery Institute, New Delhi. Believe me that the most important aspect is that we have to remain calm in this chaos. I think if this message goes into the mind of the people who are working for the company and the family members who are associated with us today in this motivational lecture, I think we have done our job. So it is all about finding the calm in the chaos. When this COVID started in December end, and for last few months, we have been reeling under it. But believe me, this is called as novel coronavirus. Novel means new coronavirus. And it has led to lot of, I would say, infections all over the country, all over the world. But again, I must say with lot of emphasis that this too shall pass. This era is not going to remain with us. If we see this coronavirus in a different format, I always feel that it has come as a god. God coronavirus, and he wants us to learn the lessons of this era. Why? Because we have the power now to introspect ourselves. God has given us the opportunity to be with our family members, and then it has done the overhauling of the nature also. All of us have seen Ganga cleaning has been done even without even a single penny. And so many birds can be seen chirping early in the morning in the skies, and so much of clarity is there. So I think one has to take it in a positive stride. And if we are positive from within, and if we are able to spread the positivity, then definitely this will go off. It is not going to stay on. And Albert Einstein had beautifully said that adversity introduces a man to himself. And in every calamity, there is an opportunity. I would not have been able to interact with you all today if this COVID era was not there. What I mean to say, because of the technology, because of so much of progress which all of us are making, and so much of time also we have at our hands, I think we should remain positive. And if we are positive, if we are positive, if our family members are having positive health also, and then we are spreading the positivity all around, the world will be a different world. It will be a new norm. I was talking to Mr. Vikram Narang in the beginning, and I asked him that what is the significance of this bulb which is shining behind you on this virtual background of Walter Bushnell. And he said that this is the era of innovation. And we strongly believe that if in the company, if we have the thoughts of innovating, then we are going to touch our 1,000 crores mark very, very fast, and maybe in 3 years. So I was telling him that I will tell you a small story about the bulb. The Thomas Alva Edison, all of us know that when he invented the bulb, and after that, can you imagine, in December 1914, the factory had 8 buildings and they caught fire because they were playing with the chemicals. So the fire was very, very fast, and all the factories, all the buildings were on fire. Thomas Alva Edison's son was standing outside. Charles was standing outside one of the factories and he was waiting for his father to come. And when Thomas Alva Edison came, he was having stone-like calmness. And this is called as stoicism. This is called as stoicism, stone-like calmness. And can you imagine? He asked Charles, "Where's your mom? Go and bring your mom." And Charles was surprised. "Papa, how can it be? All the buildings are on fire and you are thinking of calling mom from the home?" He said, "Yes, go ahead and tell her that she is not going to see such a scenario in which all our buildings are on fire." So that kind of calmness was there in the mind of Thomas Alva Edison. And there were around 10 stations, not the engines, not the 10 fire engines, but 10 stations, fire brigades were called. And ultimately, the fire was discussed in the morning at around 5:30. And he collected all the ZSMs and all the members of his team, and then not on Zoom, but physically. And only one person had died in that fire. And he said that
again, sir. Sorry to intervene, sir. आपका सर जो flap है थोड़ा pass कर लीजिए. अब voice clarity नहीं आ रही बिल्कुल भी ना. हाँ, थोड़ा सा pass कर लीजिए सर उसको.
Sure. Now you are comfortable.
Right, sir.
Yeah.
Right, sir. So, now we can hear.
Yeah. So the thinking is that he said that there is a value in disaster. All our mistakes are burnt up. Thank God we can start afresh. We can start new. And he had the meetings of all the bosses, and ultimately he conveyed that you should look for the motor parts, you should look for the building, you should find out where the money would be available. And by the same evening, they had restarted building the factory again. So thinking is that yes, one should not be negative, one should remain positive, and this too shall pass. As Mr. C.P. Goyal had also mentioned that in 1914, when there was a World War I, there was a Spanish flu also, and there were deaths of the order of 50 million because of the Spanish flu and 22 million deaths because of World War I. And then there was a Great Depression. And after that also, what I mean to say, in World War II, lot of deaths occurred. In Indo-Pak partition, so many people had been migrating from India to Pakistan or Pakistan to India. And such kind of movements were there in the history in last one century. But what happened? This too shall pass. It means this era, this COVID era, is not going to stay for long. It is going to go. And we have seen so much of innovation is going on throughout the world. We definitely are going to conquer the way, and ultimately we are going to stay. Our thinking is, especially for the younger colleagues I am mentioning, if they are going to the field, they are meeting doctors, and maybe they will not be able to do that much of business as they had been doing pre-COVID era. But if they have the integrity maintained, if they have the values in them that yes, they are working for the company and they are working with a target, definitely they are going to succeed. And for my younger colleagues, I could see when the people were introduced, any and every colleague, younger colleague, was talking to the senior persons also, and they were wishing the Guru Purnima. And I was much delighted that such kind of values are there in the company. Mr. Goyal has been in the company from 1980. So that speaks of that such kind of gurus are there in the company. So obviously the company is going to flourish. Now, this is a small story. Thank you. This is a small story about the teacher and the student. Can you imagine? One of the young persons in a marriage ceremony went to an elder man like Mr. Goyal, and he told him, "Sir, have you recognized me? The Mr. Goyal said that I don't think so that I have recognized. The young person says, sir, you were my teacher in class 3. So Mr. Goyal says, or the teacher says, that how can I recognize you in class 3? But what are you doing today? He says that I am also a teacher just because of the inspiration from you. You had inspired me to become a teacher, and that is why I have become. He says that how can at the A in the class 3, I can inspire somebody and who becomes a teacher at this age? He says that you would remember that story. I will tell you the small story, that one day I had stolen somebody's watch. And when I had stolen the watch, then when you came to the class, and then the person whose watch was stolen, he was slightly a rich boy, he had complained to you that my watch has been stolen in the class, and I obviously want it back. But as a teacher, you said that, you announced that anyone who has taken the watch, please return it back to Mr. So-and-so. But frankly speaking, I did not have the guts to open or some surrender. So I said, no, nothing doing. I am not, because I have taken the watch, but I am not going to give back the watch. And he told the teacher that ultimately, what he did was, at that time, when he was in class 3, he bolted the classroom from inside and asked every student of the class to face the wall. And when all of us started facing the wall, he told us that close the eyes and I will search the pocket of one and all. When he was searching the pocket, then you came to me, you took out the watch from my pocket, but to my utter surprise, you carried on searching the pockets of other people also. And by the end, when whole of the pockets, all the pockets were searched, then you said that now come back to your chairs, and you gave the watch to that rich boy. And you, at that time also, I was thinking that you are going to name me or you will humiliate me. But at that time, you never said anything to me. I was thinking that today I'll be called as a thief, I will be called as a dacoit, and so on and so forth. But can you imagine, after my third class to my 11th or 12th class, still you never mentioned it to anyone that I had stolen the watch. And you did not mention also to me that why did you steal the watch? And don't you remember, sir, that such kind of episode had occurred? And Mr. Goyal, as teacher, he said, believe me, I just remember the story, but how would I know that you had stolen the watch? Because at the time of searching, my eyes were also closed. So what I mean to say, this is the relationship of an excellent teacher and the student. If we have those kind of values imbibed in us, then definitely we can make a difference. And that difference, and I could see when our younger colleagues were wishing Guru Purnima to all the senior members of your team, I was much impressed. Now I am going to tell, especially to our younger colleagues who have to go to the field and meet the doctors. One has to be an optimist. One should remain a possibilist. And in this way, you should always strongly believe that one can change the way the game is played. For example, Michael Jordan, all of us know, he has been the world-renowned topmost basketball player. And he was born in 1963 in New York. And when he was 13 years old, his father called him, and they were from very poor family. His father called him and he said that, this is the shirt. What do you think about this shirt? He says that this is an old shirt. So he says that, what is the cost of this shirt? and I'm talking in a both simile for the business also, that what is the cost of this shirt? He says that it must be $1. He says that go and sell it at a cost of $2. So he took the shirt, but he was surprised that how can an old shirt and dirty shirt be sold at a cost of $2. But he tried and he went to the metro railway station in New York. And he carried on selling that shirt after ironing it. Though he did not have the iron, he had the wooden planks, and after washing it. And in the evening, he was able to sell it at the cost of $2. He ran to his father, and his father was just like I am. He was not much satisfied. And he said that, yes, good, that you, $1 shirt, you have been able to sell it at $2. But here is another shirt. So is it possible that you sell it at a cost of $20? He said, I will try. And then he went with the shirt, but he saw that even if after washing and even after doing the ironing, he would not get $20 off this $1 shirt. What he did was that he requested his cousin to draw a Mickey Mouse on the shirt. He drew a Mickey Mouse on the shirt and went to a school. And that there was a private school. And mother had come to take the son back to from the school. And mother could also see that this boy, a poor boy, is selling the shirt at a cost of $20. And it has got Mickey Mouse imprinted onto that. And she was interested in that shirt. And he said that, yes, I will pay you $20. Immediately, her son also came out with the bag from the school. And he was also happy to see the Mickey Mouse because he was a fan of Mickey Mouse. And he said that, yes, I want to buy this shirt. And he gave another $5 to Michael Jordan. So ultimately, he collected $25 and ran to his father that today I have sold the shirt of $1 at the cost of $25. Can you imagine? His father was very, very happy, but he said that now take another shirt and sell it at a cost of $200. But this time, Michael Jordan was very confident that yes, he will be able to sell it. He was thinking for 1 week and he had ironed it, washed it, ironed it, and then he came to know that there is a theater, today also it exists, that is called as Broadway Theater. In the Broadway Theater, the movie Charlie's Angels was to be played, and it was a premiere in which the actress Farah had to come. So when actress Farah came, he went into the hall, into the picture hall, movie hall, and requested Farah that is it possible to give me an autograph? He saw a poor boy of 13 years and asking for an autograph. He said, yes, I can give it. So is it possible that you can sign on this shirt? She signed on the shirt. And then Michael Jordan took that shirt outside the movie hall and started auctioning it. And when he was auctioning, started from $200, can you imagine he could sell the shirt at $1,200? $1,200, and he was very, very happy. And all of us know Michael Jordan, he learned the lesson of the story. I would ask Sachin Kapoor, now what is the lesson of the story of Michael Jordan? Sachin, do you want to respond? You are a HR man, unmute yourself and go ahead. Yeah.
Sir, I would like to respond on this that we should never give up and we should always have a positive thought in our mind and we should always spread the positive energy.
Very good.
Because if we give up on any given particular day, then it would be the end of road, not only for us, but for others also.
Wonderful. The father asked Jordan, that what had you learned out of this exercise? And Michael Jordan answered that where there is a will, there is a way. He says, no, I wanted to teach you one big lesson of life. And that is that you had done the effort to sell the $1 shirt into $2 and then $20 and then $200 and then $1,200. If you could add the value in a non-living thing like shirt, you can always do the value addition in your own life also. And Michael Jordan says that I have missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I have lost more than 300 games. 26 times I have been trusted to take the game-winning shot but missed it. I have failed over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed. Our lesson of the story, Sachin, definitely, yes, fully agreed with you. Lesson of the story is, and especially for my younger colleagues who go to the field and meet the doctors, that never ever give up. One, time, this time is not going to last forever. This too shall pass. And add the value. Value addition should be done for your visits. And if you are adding the value addition, then only you will be able to make a difference in your life and in the life of the company. Life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. And I, to my mind, it is very, very careful that one should remain positive, and that is the reason that one can make a difference. Now, Mr. Vikram had also told us that now is the time that people have started moving out of the house to meet the doctors and do their jobs. This was a lockdown period of 3.5 to 4 months in which all of us have been doing the homework from home, but we were not able to go. But at the moment, they feel not very elated, and especially the family members. And somebody was mentioning about the deaths which have occurred in their area, and especially the young people dying after getting the corona infection, after getting the COVID infection. Our thinking is that everything depends on the preparedness. As you had been, and all of us had been staying at home in last three and a half months, but today, if we are prepared to go out, unlock ourselves, our thoughts are that please take care of 1, 2, and 3 aspects. Number one aspect is SMS. S is social distancing, M is mask, and S is sanitation and hand washing. So, especially when we are going out, please do not think that social distance is not important. We have to maintain a distance of 1 meter from another person. We have to maintain lot of social distance from the negativity. We have to maintain lot of social distance from the negative news channels, which are telling us the number of deaths which are occurring day in and day out. I would not ever say that don't be get afraid of the virus. You should be. But thinking is that please wear the mask. Mask is not a big ask. Means that anywhere, everywhere, anyone goes out of the home, please support the mask on your nose, on your face, and not on your neck. Many times I have seen even highly educated people, when they are coming to my OPD, then they are wearing the mask on their neck as if it was made for the neck. No. Answer is that prevention is better than cure. You have to prevent the entry of the coronavirus into our system. The aerosols should not go into our systems, and only proven method is the mask. So if you are using the mask, N95 mask or other mask, please be careful that you are not letting the viral load come into our tract, respiratory tract, or go out of our respiratory tract. It is our moral responsibility to own that. And third is about the sanitation. I would request all of you, the younger colleagues also, that please take your own personal sanitizer, enter the hospital, use the sanitizer, and then handle the medicines or the counter or whatsoever. But again, believe on thorough hand cleaning also. Means that you should wash your hands on both the sides, inside, palmar aspect, outside, and in between the webs also, so that we are taking care of our health first, investing in our health. If we are healthy, we will definitely make sure that our family members are also healthy and our company people are also healthy, and then our city and centers, everyone will be happy. So in this context, I must tell you that there is a small story. In this, what happened was that one of the ZSMs, or even the boss CEO of the company, he was having a farmhouse close to Antarctica Sea. And in this Antarctica Sea, lot of tides and waves will come and can destroy the farmhouse. So he advertised for the job that if somebody is taking care of my farmhouse, I will pay him so much. People used to join, but after a few days, for the fear, they would leave the job, because they were always sleeping with this thought that storm will come at night and everything will be over. One of the smart persons, I would say like person like Vijay Pratap, from Walter Bushnell, he was interviewed and he said that I can do the job at your farmhouse. The CEO of the company said that how can you do the job? He says that I can sleep when the wind blows. Frankly, he did not understand what did he mean by I can sleep when the wind blows. He said that, okay, you are on the job. And can you imagine after 4 days of his job, the storm is coming and they were sleeping. The CEO of the farmhouse or the company, he got up and he woke up Vijay Pratap, and he said that, go ahead, man, get up fast because the storm is coming in the Antarctic Sea. And Vijay says, I can sleep when the wind blows. When I had taken the interview, I had told you that I can sleep when the wind blows. The CEO did not understand and he went out. And when he went out to take care of the farm, he was surprised that everything which could be taken away by the storm was placed in a right order. Means the cattle were also tied. The hay husk, the bundle was also tied nicely. The cycle or other, all the boat also, they were kept in such a safe custody that even if the storm comes in that farm, nothing can go wrong. So thinking is that ultimately it is a matter of preparedness. If we have prepared ourselves in last 3.5 to 4 months, and now once we are venturing out of our homes to pay the visits to the doctors, to other people, I think you have done a great job of setting the targets. And I am absolutely sure that if you are first taking care of your health and then you are concerned about the health of the doctors, of the healthcare workers when you go to the hospital, and then you maintain a social distance, there is no point of any worry about that. I would ask Mr. Vijay Pratap. Vijay, what do you see in this photograph? Is it possible to unmute Vijay and tell him? Vijay?
Yes, sir.
What do you
see? Sir, one girl is standing in front of mountains, or you can say one jharna is there, sir. both can be visible.
So hi, what do you think, Subhai?
At the first instance, I saw a girl, a lady.
Right. What I mean to say, yes, both of you are right, that it is not what you see, it is how you see. This is a waterfall in Peru, and it is called as Bridal Waterfall in Peru. So you can see the waterfall and you can see the girl, but you can definitely see the people who are standing close to the waterfall also. So what I mean to say, it all depends on what is in your mind. If you are interested in seeing the girl, you will see the girl. If you are seeing the waterfall, you will be able to see the waterfall. And if you are able to focus on this positive method thing, then you will be able to see the positivity. So our thinking is that please do not remain negative, be positive. If you are positive, if you are going out of work, you should not be bothered about whatsoever is happening to ABC, but definitely we should take lot of precautions so that ultimately the coronavirus is staying away and we are not getting invaded by that virus. Again, believe me that the reason of the success of anyone is this frog story. These are the frogs, and they thought that on 15th of August, for example, in the 7 a.m., we will have a race, and that race will start, and we have to reach the top of the mountain, and on the top of the mountain is a target of 1,000 crore. So we have to reach the target of 1,000 crore. So all the frogs had gathered on 15th of August early in the morning. But can you imagine that there were more onlookers? There were more, I put them into a category of criticizers. So many people had gathered outside that park and they wanted to see that how could it be that frogs have taken a dream of reaching the top of the mountain or reaching the target of 1,000 crores. So let us see. And can you imagine, as soon as the race started, many frogs started running, but many started falling also. And ultimately, when they were running, the onlookers were very, very happy that this frog has fallen, another one has fallen, but there was one frog which carried on and reached the top of the mountain. And when he reached the top of the mountain, the onlookers, the criticizers who were making so much of noise when they were standing outside, they were surprised that how could it be that most of the frogs have fallen off, but one frog has reached the top. So they started asking the frogs that why did you not go up to the top of the mountain? The one answer was, oh, I was very comfortable in whatever salary I was getting. So why should I make an effort to reach the top of the mountain? Another one says that, yes, I was running at a nice speed, but another person had given me a push, and that is the reason that ultimately I had fallen. And so on and so forth. So many people, so many frogs started giving the excuses. The onlookers were not happy. The criticizers were not happy that why the one frog could reach the top of the mountain. And they started interviewing. Mr. Durgesh Pratap, what do you think that why that frog could reach the top of the mountain and others could not reach? Why, please unmute yourself, why that frog could make a 1,000, meet the 1,000 target, but others could not?
Because the reason is very simple. Because he is focusing on what he had to do. He is not listening that what the other people are saying. That is the why he has to achieve his goal and reach on the top of the mountain or top
Durgesh,
of the tree.
Durgesh Pratap ji,
Haan, sir.
The frog was deaf.
That's why, sir. This is a story, na?
Right. If so you have to be right. No, you are right. You are right. You have to be deaf to the negative comments. There will be many people, even in our team sitting over here. Many are there who will demotivate, but they will be number one.
Yeah.
This is their strategy, right?
Yeah.
So you should never listen to the negative comments. Be deaf.
Durgesh and Vikram, both of you are absolutely right in putting in a good perspective that ultimately you have to be deaf to the criticism. If you are deaf to the criticism, then only you will be reaching the top. What I mean to say, if you are having a habit that what's done is done, what's gone is gone, one of the life's lesson is to always keep moving on. I always say that even if you are going through,
great.
Keep moving. Even if you, Vikram, even if you are going through hell, keep moving, because that is the only way you will come out. So our thinking is that we should carry on moving, and especially our younger colleagues, I know the leadership is there, we should always push the younger colleagues to move on in a positive spirit. Definitely target is not far off, and we should be averse to negativity. We should be deaf to the criticism. Excellent. Now, another small story. As Mr. Nishant Barlia is, I know Nishant and Madam Barlia for long, many years, and they have been family friends. So this Nishant, the boss of the company, was, for example, was the boss of the General Motors. And he received a complaint from somebody that I had bought a Pontiac car, and this Pontiac car is absolutely new, but it is misbehaving with me. How it is misbehaving? He says that after the dinner, when we decide to go for buying the ice cream, when I go and buy the vanilla ice cream, when I come back, the car would not start. When I go and buy strawberry or chocolate or all American sundae, the car will start. And Mr. Barlia, as the CEO of General Motors, was surprised that how could it be that car is allergic to vanilla ice cream and not to any other ice cream. So he requested the engineer that please go and find out and do the servicing of the car. The engineers went to the person and did the servicing. They did not find any complaint. And can you imagine, the CEO of the General Motors was not a person who would not go into details. According to him, God lies in details. Devil also lies in details. He would say that Mr. So-and-so, please go to the person's home at the time of dinner. And if you go with him to buy the ice cream, just check that if he buys vanilla, then it would start or not. And if he buys strawberry or other ice creams, they will start. And then give me the details of these visits. And the engineer went along. When he came back after buying the vanilla ice cream, the car would not start. Next day, the car would start. Then, can you imagine, sitting at the top of the company, he said that, and he told the engineer, though himself he was not an engineer, but he said that, is it possible to time it? That how much time it takes for him to buy the vanilla ice cream and how much time it takes for him to buy the strawberry and other ice creams? And ultimately, he came to know that vanilla ice cream buying was available at the counter. And it was just a few seconds, and he would hand over the ice cream and then he would go back and the car would not start. But the other ice creams were inside the store, or it would take time to make the All-American sundae. And then when he reaches his car, the car would start. He says, the Mr. Barlia, or the at the General Motors CEO, he tells his engineer that go and change the vapor lock. And once you change the vapor lock in the combustion, then the car would start. And ultimately, sitting at that level, he could see the problem, and that problem couldn't be met in. So Vikram, what do you think? That what is the lesson of the story which we wanted to give? Or you can ask your younger colleagues, anyone for that matter, what is the lesson of the story in this General Motors and Pontiac?
Sumita, would you like to answer? Sumita.
Sumita, unmute yourself.
Sir, he is an inspiration for many of us. He is number one ZSM for India as YPM is concerned.
Sumita, unmute yourself.
Sumit hospital gaya hai na?
Nahin, nahin,
aa gaya hai sir. Operation ho gaya hai.
Haan, batao, batao.
Operation was successful.
Yes.
The thing is that practically being a leader, we have to understand the timing and what is actually required to be done. If we understand the timing and if we can actually, being a leader, play a small instrumental role to unlock the deadlock, then the success is going to come.
Very good.
Very Milen, nice.
Would you like to add, Milen?
Yeah. So in fact, sir, when we are on top,
हमारी सेल्स take... हमारी सेल्स की लैंग्वेज में इसे क्या बोलते हैं
सर प्रॉब्लम ढूंढो जहां प्रॉब्लम है प्रॉब्लम
रूट कॉज एनालिसिस दिस इज नोन एज रूट कॉज एनालिसिस यू हैव टू गो टू
इट इज नोन एज
रूट कॉज एनालिसिस रूट कॉज
वंडरफुल आई मस्ट गिव यू अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट फॉर दैट अल्टीमेटली इफ यू आर top end, if he has that kind of thought that God lies in details and devil also lies in details and no complaint is frivolous in the sense that many times many of the companies have the culture that if for example Dr. Bhatia has got some complaint with some product and obviously the person who is meeting Dr. Bhatia would not even tell the boss or the ZSM that this is the complaint or this is the challenge which is occurring. For example, many times I have seen the drugs which are told to us as surgeons, as doctors, they are not available in the market. And if they are not available in the market, and if I write that medicine and one of the phone call comes from the chemist, that what kind of medicine have you written? We have never heard about it. I think the job is not done properly. So basic philosophy is that we should go into details. We should be prepared. We should do our homework in such a manner that it is available at all the places and then only we'll be able to make a difference. So, and another big lesson is never ever give up. As we had mentioned, that can you imagine that this frog is in the mouth of the stork and till the last moment it is trying its best to hold the stork by the neck so that the stork is dead and the frog is going to play. This is the coronavirus and these are we, in the sense we should try our best to hold the neck of the stork, never ever give up. If you give up, then obviously you have lost the battle at all. And as Zig Ziglar, the motivational speaker, always says, the real opportunity for success lies within the person and not in the job. I think this message should go to all the zonal managers and everyone, that you have to add the value in your own self. Once you do the value addition, then you will be successful and you will be able to make that score of 1,000 crores. So it is opportunity for success. And as we had seen, that after adversity, convert them into an advantage. And Dennis Green had beautifully written, the secret to success is to start from scratch and keep on scratching. If you carry on scratching, then only that means you carry on moving, then only you will be able to make a difference. In this small story, I love to convey a lot. Can you imagine this Charles Blondin? He was walking from one height to another height on a tightrope. And on the tightrope walk, he is carrying a wooden pane, and plus he is carrying his own son on his shoulder. And when he started walking from a mountain to another mountain, and when he reached the other side, everyone clapped that how could it be that such a fast flowing water in the Niagara Falls, and he could come after balancing himself on a tight rope, and that too carrying his son on the shoulder and with such a big cane in his hand. Everyone wanted to have a selfie with him. But can you imagine, when Charles reached this side, he asked people that, do you have the belief that I can go back? Everyone says, yes, yes, you can go back. We can bet over it. He says that, are you sure that you trust me? Yes, say, we trust you. You can always go back. If you have come all the way from that side of the mountain to this side, you can always go back, and we are absolutely certain. Then he says, is it possible that I can carry your son on my shoulders? Everyone was silenced. That now, what do you think, Vikram? What was the difference when he brought his son versus some other son? What was the difference?
Sir, the reason was, when he was thinking that this is his own son, then the commitment level will be on the higher side as compared to the son of the other.
No,
also, but sir, no one wants to be keep his life in danger. Keeping his life in danger, nobody wants to get to the goal. This is a general human psychology.
Yeah. So I want to say, in this situation, that there is a difference between trust and belief. Well, if you can create the trust in the mind of the doctors, trust in the mind of the people, and it is said, beautifully said, that to be trusted, it is a greater compliment than being loved. So if you can create that trust, that as you had also mentioned in the beginning, that we are with you, don't worry, anything goes wrong or anything positive or negative, in this COVID era, we are with you, trust, and you have reposed that trust. And if that person, the juniors, also put back the same trust onto you, then obviously the success is yours. There is a difference between belief and trust. So I would request you all, especially the younger ones, to create that trust in the seniors, in the minds of the seniors, as well as in the minds of the doctors, that you are working for the mankind, you are working for the humankind, and ultimately you are not shying away from any responsibility. Once you have come to meet a doctor, you have created that trust, and your doctor will always make it a point that he is not going to prove you wrong. And that is the, I would say, be intentional. If you are working with intention that you have to make a difference, you will be able to make a difference, and you will always win that doctor, and your business will flourish like anything. I know many of your younger colleagues do this way. They go out of the way. They go extra mile. There is no congestion in that extra mile. And that is a reason that Walter Bushnell has been successful to that level. I am very much delighted about it. One small story.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, one small story about the seeds you sow. Can you imagine, Mr. Vikram, he wanted to make another CEO, and he called all his younger colleagues that this time we are not going to take the just immediate juniors, but we will make the CEO of the company from the younger lot. And he called anyone and everyone and gave them one seed each, that take this seed, and after the lockdown period, you see me and tell me after 4 months, for example, that what thing has been done from that seed. And can you imagine, Mr. Vijay also got the seed and others also got the seed. Everyone used to talk after 1 week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks that my seed I have sown into the soil and it has grown and it has started giving the plant. Some of the people would say that it has started flowering also, but Vijay's seed would not be bearing any plant or any flower. And at the end of 3.5 months, then Mr. Vikram calls all the young people that what, show me what have you done in last 3.5 months of lockdown. And everyone brought the planter, everyone brought the plants, and then this man Vijay was standing at the corner. And when Mr. Vikram started asking that where is your flower, where is your plant, everyone was very happy to show the plant and the flower. But Vijay was hiding behind at the corner, and he asked that, Vijay, where is your planter? Where is your flower? Where is your plant? He says, sorry, sir, I could not bring any plant or any flower because this is my planter in which I had sown the seed, but nothing has come out. Nothing has come out. Even if I had watered it, my wife had watered it regularly, but nothing has come out. And everyone, all the members of the senior members of the team, they started laughing at Mr. Vijay. Vijay, I know you don't mind it, but everyone started laughing that how could it be that his seed has not grown, but rest all the people had the plants and the flowers. And at the end, he called his Sachin Kapoor also, the HR man, that today I'm going to announce that the CEO of the company would be Mr. Vijay. Everyone was surprised that how could it be that Vijay has not been able to plant that seed and no plant, no flower, no leaves have come out. How could it be that the Vijay could be made the CEO of the company? And can you imagine, he said, I am making the CEO of the company because I had given the seed, which was boiled, to one and all. To one and all, and I knew it, that none of these seeds would grow any plant or any flower, but all of you have changed that seed and ultimately brought the plant and the flower, except for Vijay. He has not been able to change it. What is the lesson of the story? Mr. Vikram, you can ask anyone. What is the lesson of the story?
Sir, we are having one of the very interesting attempts, that is Shebalda. He will, because he is in the habit of doing this. Eh? Shebalda? Shebalda?
Can do anything.
Sir, the issue is of integrity.
Very good.
The issue is of honesty and integrity. That in spite of the, it was not getting germinated, still he kept on doing the work which was told to him, and ultimately everybody manipulated, but the truth came out at the end, that it was not going to germinate. Somehow they were trying to manipulate and bring out that plant, but he was honest, and a person who is always would like to have a CEO who is honest, who has a very strong integrity. He will be helpful for the company to grow further.
Wonderful. I am very good. Mr. Roy, about the answer, that ultimately it is the question of integrity.
Vikram sir has asked the question from the right person.
This is the job of Vikram. He gets money because of this only. He can identify the heads of the people.
Thank you, sir.
Good job. So our thinking is that our younger colleagues, and especially us also, all of us should have that maintained integrity. If that integrity is maintained, then only the company will be able to reach the target. If our integrity is not made, if we set the target, and if we dwindle in between, and if we are not true to ourselves, then obviously the target will not be achieved. And I think Mr. Roy has beautifully summed up all his experience in answering that puzzle. Now, another small story, that this is a, many times, many of us at the leadership positions like Vikram or Mr. Roy or Durgesh, that we are having a dilemma and we have to take a decision. Some decision has to be made, whether we should start the working now or whether we should carry on working with the home from home. So what is the right time, whether we should risk it or not. So this is a decision making story. And in this, you can appreciate that the train is coming from a distance and it is coming at a high speed. And there is a junction, and on the junction, the lines are dividing into two. And can you imagine the guard is standing here and he has the power of changing the levers. All of us must have seen the way on the train when the divider is there, he has to just pull the lever and then the train can move in the same track or it can change the track. Now, the story is that on the track at which the train was coming, there were four children who were playing. And there was a adjoining track on which there were two children who were playing on the unused track. So I would say, put it this way, there was an unused track which, in which some repair work was going on, and then there were only two children who were playing, and whereas on the live track, that means the train was coming, there were more than four children who were playing. So, and he, the distance of the train to this junction is very small. So he has to put the lever in such a way that either the children who are playing on a wrong track, they are killed, or the other track on which it is a usual normal running track, the train is going. So what shall you do when you are a guard at that level? Vikram, you can ask the intelligent person.
Sir, for this, the situation is the similar which Mr. Chopra is facing. Chopra sir, किसको मारना चाहो? किसको मारना चाहोगे? बताओ. Chopra ji, किसे मारना चाहोगे?
Sir, in fact, अगर बात करें मारना तो किसी को नहीं चाहोगे. But when there is an decision, take decision. It is a very difficult situation. But definitely, when the person who are on right track, which is a closed track, they are playing, they are having nothing fault on that. So in any case, we can't give them this punishment to be on this, being on a right track. Who are on the wrong track, so the person, the that as per my knee, the decision will go to kill those persons who are on wrong.
So that means you will change the track so that the train goes to a wrong track, unused track.
No. That is the person who are on wrong track. The track which is moving, the train which is going on the track. So I will keep it on that. The track which is already closed. So because this is a closed track and the two children are there, I will not change it to those. Those tracks. So they are having nothing, their fault in it. So why to keep, why to give the punishment?
So you are definitely interested in killing maybe four or five children who are playing on a right, the moving track, but you are not at all ready to punish those children who are playing on a wrong track, right? This is the answer?
Who are playing on a closed track.
On a closed track. So there is no fault of theirs.
Mr. Shastri?
Yes.
Do you agree, Mr. Shastri?
Mr. Shastri.
Again, very intelligent person. You will kill all the children, right? why they are playing. They should play.
Shastri ji, unmute yourself.
Shastri?
Sir, here we have to take decision of so that casualties are less. So we can minimize the casualties and keep going.
So what shall you do when you are at the position of the guard? You have to make a decision.
Sir, it will in normal track. It will allow as per the train go in normal track.
Right. So all the children who are playing on the track, normal track, they will be killed. But those people who are not playing on a normal track, but they know the train does not come, they will obviously be carrying on playing. Right.
Yes.
Sir, can we train us in the football? Are we just saying, sir?
Pardon, Durgesh.
Sir, can we have one option also, when the train is coming, we can put the train on the hold board by pulling the chain, and then we can shift that guy from that and also that. Well, both the lives have been saved, and wonderful. Then we can go for that only.
Wonderful. Anyone else?
Jha saab, ye Bihar mein train aayegi to kya karoge?
नहीं सर, वो तो खैर बिहार हो चाहे इंडिया कहीं भी हो.
सर, योर वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग.
एक सिचुएशन, क्या आवाज आ रही है मेरी?
यस यस, मिस्टर झा.
हां, आ रही है.
सर, ऑडिबल. इन दिस केस फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट एक्चुअली इफ वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट दिस फोर, बिकॉज़ दिस फोर पीपल और दिस चिल्ड्रन एक्चुअली विजिबल टू अस एट एनी कॉस्ट. हियर ओनली एक्चुअली टू थिंग कैन हैपन. कोई तो कोई यहां एक्सीडेंट का भुक्तभोगी होगा. तो फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट इफ एट फर्स्ट साइट वी कैन सेव दिस फोर चिल्ड्रन, and at the same time immediately this driver can be given some option that he should apply brake or something like that. He can take some corrective step to protect, because we are not sure whether this train is full of passenger or the vacant train. Ho sakta hai ki is train mein passenger.
You have touched the note, but in a slightly different manner. Most of you, I would put it this way, have been entrapped into thinking about two children versus four children. But we are not at all thinking about the passengers in the train. The train is having so thousands of passengers. We are thinking about two and four. What I mean to say, the guard will not ask the person to apply a sudden brake. If the sudden brake is applied, the train can get derailed, and then lot of casualties can occur, lot of damage can occur. The train will carry on moving on a right moving track because it is under speed. And if it is on the speed, then the children also know that this is a running track. They will, as soon as they see that the train is coming, they will go from east side to this side, and all of them will be safe. So our thinking is, what is the lesson of the story? Lesson of the story is, our decisions should be made in such a manner that we have to see the broader perspective. It should never be seen as if that yes, two versus four, but we should be able to see the whole of the company. Then only we will be able to make the decisions in a right manner. We should have thought about the passengers who are traveling in the train, and about the damage it would cause if it is put on a wrong track, or then it would have been different. So think on a broader perspective, one. And second thing is, I would urge our younger colleagues that please read books. It is very, very important. If the younger colleagues have a habit of reading the books, a person who won't read has no advantage over who cannot read. And for that, I would say that such kind of books by Sun Tzu, that every battle is won before it is fought. This Art of War is a beautiful book, and I would urge Mr. Vikram to distribute this book to one and all from the company side, and then they will be able to equip themselves how to know your enemy. Enemy in this case is coronavirus, and how to know your own self. If you know the enemy, if you know yourself, then obviously you should not be afraid of 100 battles. Thinking is that we should add the value addition in ourselves. We should know the enemy very well. then definitely we are going to reach the target of 1,000 crores. Again, many stories are there, but to cut this story short, I would definitely say that this was a World War II, and the planes would go into the battlefield, and when they come back, they have a lot of bullet injuries on both rear end as well as on the engine end. And it was seen that on the rear end, bullet injury densities was more as compared to engine side, where the bullet injuries were less. Then the provision was there of putting in a shield on one way, that means either on the rear end or on the front end. So on which side would you put the shield so that ultimately the injuries are less? You have understood the question that the planes which come back from the war, they have the bullet injuries. The rear end has more bullet injuries. The engine side has less bullet injuries. So, and there is a provision of placing in a bulletproof shield on one side of the plane. So where shall you put the shield? Milind, go ahead.
So the shield has to be on the front.
Right. Why?
See, because it is not the question of right side or wrong side. It is the question, it is the pilot who takes the decision. And it depends on the pilot, how he protects his entire plane. It is who drives the pilot. That the complete story is depend on the pilot who takes up the decision.
Right. Any other person, Vikram? You debut anyone who can answer?
Partha?
Sir, this shield has to be pasted on the engine side only, because engine is more important for the flight, so that it take off and take on. So, engine side only.
But as I mentioned that the bullets are having more density on the rear side as compared to the engine side. What do you think?
Vinod?
Rear.
Vinod?
Mr. Vinod?
Vinod, unmute yourself.
You want it to be put on the engine side because that is the more useful. I think without that, plane is not going to land.
Which side?
Engine side, sir.
Why?
The ultimate engine is the main thing.
Right.
But again, I
think all of you are answering in the same tone. My answer to this is, and can you imagine, this Abraham Wald was the mathematician. And he was the only person who was telling that it should be placed on the engine side. Rest all the engineers in that World War II, they were telling that it should be placed on the rear side. Why? Because the bullets are more in number. And everyone was surprised that how could it be that you are differing as compared to others. Others are thinking that because the bullets are more on the rear side, so obviously we should put it on more on the rear side. But Abraham Wald was the mathematician. He said that think out of the box. You are thinking about the planes which have come back, and then you are counting the bullet density on the planes which have come back. But you are not thinking about the planes which have been crashed at the battlefield. Those planes who had been lost, or the pilots who have been lost on the battlefield, they have to be taken into account. And that is the reason that it should be put onto the engine side rather than on rear side. And the moral of the story is that think out of the box. Think from a broader perspective. If you are thinking from a broader perspective, then only we'll be able to make a difference. Positive minds don't judge. Our thinking is, and especially to Vikram, I am saying, don't be judgmental. Definitely, there will be some situations in which any and everyone can be different and can make a different answer to that. And now, I think the last story is that again, one should think out of the box, and I will narrate in between the question answer session. But I would request that all of you should be ready with the questions and should bombard in this session so that all of us are learners rather than become learners. And if you can catch hold of this book also, Good to Great. This is by Jim Collins. Good is the enemy of great. So I always ask my younger colleagues whether they want to become good or they want to become great. So most of the times people say that we want to become good, or the smarter people, they want to become great. So thinking is that if you want to become great, then anticipate 3 steps. If you want to be good, then you can anticipate 1 step. In this story also, Dhanvir story, Krishna and Arjun, and they wanted to have an havan, and then they went to Yudhishthir and Karna on separate day. Everyone was saying that you are partial to Krishna, that you are partial to Karna, that you always call him as a Dhanvir Karna, whereas the Yudhishthir is also doing the best job. But can you imagine when they went on day one to Yudhishthir, they asked for the wood for the havan. But on those days, the rains were occurring. And the Yudhishthir ordered his soldiers to go and bring back the wood. And in the evening, when they came, both Krishna and Arjun came, he handed over the wood to them. But because it was wet, because of the rains, obviously it will not be useful for the havan. But whereas Karna, he could anticipate that the wood would not burn, because for last 4 days there it has been raining. So he broke his door, and then he could collect the sandalwood and then give it to Krishna and Arjun, and ultimately that made the difference. And that is the reason what we say, that anticipate 1 step versus 3 steps. Love what you do and do what you love. If you are going to make a difference in the company, then you have to think of 3 steps further up, and that will make the difference. The evil you do remains with you. The good you do always comes back to you. So our thinking is, as those values have to be there, and if you have the values imbibed by your parents, especially for my younger colleagues who have small children, I would tell them that this was the mother, this was the lady who used to keep a roti outside on the wall every day. And this hunchback old man would come, pick up the roti and go off, but he would announce, the evil you do remains with you, the good you do always comes back to you. And this woman was surprised that every day she would make a roti, place it on the wall, this hunchback old man would come and then take the roti, but never ever thank the lady. And can you imagine, one day after months and months of this exercise, she thought that this is not the way, that he is taking my roti every day. I am preparing roti for him. It is a hot roti, but every day he announces, the evil you do remains with you, the good you do always comes back to you. And she thought that I will poison the roti. I will poison the roti today. And then she kept the poisoned roti outside on the wall. And after some time, that old man came. But before he could touch the roti, she had a feeling that he would announce, the evil you do remains with you, the good you do comes back to you. She took back the roti, put it into the fire, and made another roti and again placed it, because she started introspecting. And then, as luck would have it, in the evening her son was supposed to come back. When he came back, he was very thin and fragile. And she asked that, what happened? You have been not taking roti or lunch for so many days. You have been so thin and fragile. He says that, no, I have not been taking roti. But today, on the way, when I was coming, I was on the verge of collapsing when an old man met me, and he said that, I have got the roti for you. You can take that roti. And that roti was eaten by me. And as soon as I had taken the roti, the old man went off, and he said that, evil you do remains with you, the good you do always comes back to you. Means that if she had poisoned that roti, obviously she would have killed her son. So our thinking is that, have those values, have those integrity, have the positivity in the mind, edit your life frequently and ruthlessly. It is your masterpiece after all. Positivity travels in generations. We know about Walter Bushnell Company. We know father of Mrs. Berlia and Mr. Berlia and the children. So the positivity is there in the family, and that should carry on working in generations, and that will create a difference. If somebody says that, how can I make a difference? This was a boy who was standing outside the seashore, and lot many fish were coming out. He was throwing one fish back into the sea. Somebody like me went to him, what are you doing? He says that I am making a difference. Then the person like me, he asked that, how can you make a difference? You are standing on the seashore. So many waves are coming. So many fish are dying. So many fish are going back. But you are just throwing one fish back into the sea. And his answer was, I am making a difference in the life of that fish which I am throwing back. What I mean to say, never ever think that Mr. Jha is not working properly, or Mr. Durgesh is not working properly, or XYZ is not working properly. Why should I work properly? Our thinking is no. We should be answerable to our own self. We should be honest. We should have the integrity. Even the darkest night will end and the sun is going to rise. Believe me, as younger colleagues, I think Mr. Das and Mr. Jha and Mr. Goel, all of us are from the old generation. Maybe we are able to put the pebbles into the matka and then the water will come up. But now the younger colleagues should use the modern technology of taking the water from the matka by using a straw, by using the equipment, by using the Zoom, by using the technology. And I would say that this is the time that we should upgrade our skills, we should upgrade our thoughts, and then ultimately, in the end, I would end by saying, Subhani was also mentioning, that I have a mantra, and that is called as Sar Jai Par Sair Na Jai. We should invest in our own health. We should remain positive. Harkat mein barkat hai, that we should carry on moving even if you are going through hell. Jaan hai to jahan hai, means take care of your health. If you are positive, if you are healthy, if you are able to survive this onslaught of corona in 2020, that is enough. We will be able to make a difference. We will be able to reach the target of 1,000 crores. Then, choti soch aur pair ki moch, kisi ko aage nahi badhne deti. I think this is one of my favorite quotes, that if you have a small thought, and if so, choti soch aur pair ki moch, kisi ko aage nahi badhne deti. Aur last mein, I would say, cut one mark if possible. And I will especially, for the family members, for the children of the family members, I would present this way. I'm not boasting of. In my class 9th and 10th, when the mathematics paper was there, examination was there, at the end of the examination, mathematics exam, I used to write, cut one mark if possible. I was so confident in mathematics. In physics, we used to get a question paper, not the MCQs, but the question paper in which it was written, attempt any 7 out of 10 questions. And I would say, I have attempted 10, check any 7. So ultimately, answer is, it is an attitude. If an attitude is positive, if you remain positive, if you are a hardworking man, if it is better to burn out than fade away, the success will be yours. And please, for God's sake, believe on safety. It is very, very important at this stage that you should have a safe behavior. You should not start thinking of quitting and jumping from one company to another. We should remain safe with the company. We should work for the company, for the upscaling of our own self. Then definitely we are going to make a difference. I would, at the end, say, stay flexible, stay tuned, stay positive, stay at home, and stay healthy. And that is going to create a difference. Thank you very much. God bless you all. Now I am definitely open for any questions which you want to ask from me. Thank you.
It was a great session, sir. It has really motivated all of us. And now we are thinking that 1,000 crore is nothing. We should clap, sir, for you.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
Because the type of positive energy which you have given and rightly said by you, everything is there in the mind, sir. Whatever the mind will think, that only will do. Great. Now we'll start with the question answer. So the first question, who will ask the first question from the sir?
Sir, me.
Oh, boy.
Mr. Vijay Pratap has a question. Mr. Vijay Pratap.
Sir. This is my question, that how to focus on work when all the times we are thinking about COVID-19.
I think most important aspect is that please remain positive. Corona is going to go. And believe me, from a doctor's function, I am saying that 95% of the people, even if they get infected with coronavirus, they will be absolutely fine after a normal flu. Only 5% will have some consequences, and only those people will have the consequences who are having some comorbidities like diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, and so on and so forth. And only 3%, 2.5 to 3% will ultimately deteriorate to ventilator level. So thinking is that be positive. Even if I get the coronavirus, I will be able to scan through. 95% people are okay. So why should I be bothered? Why should I not be okay? Our thinking is that invest in your health, remain positive, have the positive thoughts. If you are busy with the positive work, obviously coronavirus will come but will go also, and it will not change your path. Remain positive, remain healthy. Do exercise of 45 minutes every day in the morning and take good diet, balanced diet, so that you are not having any respiratory challenge, and that will make coronavirus go off. Thank you.
Second question is by Mr. Ajay Chopra, sir.
Yeah, Mr. Chopra.
Yes, sir. Sir, how can we enhance positive thinking?
How can we have the enhancement of positive thinking?
Yes,
I would say, and this question was asked by Vikram also in the session just before joining, that I answered that दूसरों को मेहंदी लगाने से अपने हाथों की मेहंदी गाड़ी हो ही जाती. If I am trying to be positive and I am spreading this positivity, if I am trying to be happy and I am spreading the happiness, obviously I will be happier. I will be happy. So same way, my thinking is, let the negativity go off, remain positive, and then this positivity will carry on having a snowball effect, and that will make your younger colleagues also positive. And then ultimately, once they are satisfied with their job, once they are positive, then they will be able to satisfy the doctors, and the company is going to flourish. So remain positive, maintain a safe distance from the negative people also, from the negative news also, from the negative news channels also. Don't count the number of infections and number of deaths every day.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, before we move ahead to the next question, I will request all our audiences, all our medical representatives, our area managers, if you have any questions, you can text those questions to your zonal managers, so they can also take up your questions. Okay, so the third question is from Mr. Shaibul Roy.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes.
If you can provide some tips for what you call how to promote positive thinking. The reason behind is that, sir, what happened during the Spanish flu, we do not know. But with this COVID, what very interesting and very significant thing, apart from the fact that the mortality rate is very low with COVID infection. But what I find is that it's a social implication is very strong. Because, sir, I'm from Calcutta, you know, there are a lot of people are suffering from COVID, but the society as a whole is behaving very strangely. If people are having a little bit of symptoms, if they have been identified, and if the government is trying to take any measures, unka jo wo aas paros mein jo aadmi rehte hain, itna strangely unke saath behave kar rahe hain ki you just cannot imagine. Only three to four days back, Mr. Kapoor knows one of my FSO, his father ultimately he passed away. He was suffering from diabetes. He was having a very high score, and ultimately he succumbed to the infection. Now, yesterday and day before yesterday, we called him up and he said that I am now praying to God that we should not have any infection, because the mohalla where he is staying, everybody is looking upon them very lowly, and they are very afraid that what will happen to them, whether they are positive or negative. The society is behaving very rudely and very strangely. So that is more important, that we should have a very positive mind setup, because that is most important right now, because the infection, you cannot prevent, you cannot stop that infection, and the mortality rate is low. So there is no apparent as such danger out of it, but society is behaving in such a way that lot of people are, wo kya hota na sir, wo ekdam, they are getting very, ek jagah mein wo ekdam shell mein chala ja rahe. How to prevent that? And the positive thinking maybe will give a lot of answer to that.
Yeah, I think, Mr. Roy, I would say that the stigma attached with coronavirus has gone very high, especially in India and not outside. Believe me, both of my sons are in US, and one is a surgeon and another is working in robotic surgery. They say that people do not attach that kind of stigma if somebody is positive. But here, I 100% endorse your viewpoint. But again, it all depends on the mindset. It all depends on the attitude. And for this, I would love to recite a small story. A story is that one of the person was sent from India to South Africa, and he was working in a shoe company. And when he reached the South Africa, he immediately dialed back the people higher ups in India that, please call me back. I will not be able to sell these shoes. And the people were surprised that how could it be? He said that in South Africa, no one wears the shoes. So ultimately, how can I sell the shoes there? Nobody wears the shoes. And he was called back. Then another person like Mr. Roy was sent to South Africa. And as soon as he reached South Africa, he said that, send me truckloads of shoes. They said, how and why? And answer was, no one wears the shoes here. So I will be able to sell the shoes in a big number. So answer is an attitude. If the attitude is positive, you should always tell your friend that this is not going to last. It is a transient phenomenon. You have to be deaf to those criticizers, to those people who are naysayers. And time is going to tell. Time is the best healer. Time is going to tell that, yes, this can happen to anyone, any family member. But we should take all precautions. Once we are taking all precautions, everything will be absolutely fantastic. So remain...
Sir, thank you very much for opening South Africa for us. We now have a JSM to be posted at South Africa.
All right.
Mr. Shubhal Roy.
And he should ask for more shoes, truckloads of shoes.
Yes, sir. Pura jahaj bhejdenge, sir.
Exactly.
Jahaj.
Good one.
All right. So the next question is from Mr. Ashutosh Jha.
Ashutosh Jha, right. From Bihar.
Yes, sir. Ashutosh ji, aapka mute hai. Please unmute yourself.
Good evening.
So yeah, good evening, sir. First of all, just I would like to appreciate, because today's program was one of the best presentation I have seen. So thank you very much, sir, for today's presentation. Actually, my question is very simple, and I would like to put it in a very short way. Actually, we are already concerned about ourselves, our team, and our professional world. But actually, there is also one world, actually, a world of housewives. So my question relates with the housewives only. So in this COVID era, how can they best utilize time at home apart from regular domestic work which she is performing every day? So this is my very simple question, especially for the housewives.
For the housewives, again, the answer is loud and clear that stay positive. Stay positive, enjoy cooking. Enjoy the work which you have not been doing, for example, and try to upscale your skill set. That if, for example, if you have not been using, maybe drawing paintings, you should, one should draw it. One should encourage them. And I know so many housewives and so many friends' wives who have not been singing before the COVID era, but now they have learned by YouTube how to sing, how to cook, how to make a life better. So our thinking is that, again, it is a attitude, it is a mindset. If that kind of mindset is there, then please do not overthink. If you start over, वो कहते हैं ना कि ज़्यादा सोचने से फैसले कमजोर पड़ जाते हैं। तो ज़्यादा सोचने की ज़रूरत नहीं है। Only thing is action लेने की ज़रूरत है। और action में, if you can ask them to upgrade their skill set in any manner, if they definitely will enjoy the time. And plus, I think what we have been doing is we have been running after our ambitions. Our ambitions were running after us. But this is the time of lockdown that we, all the family members, have been able to devote much time to the family. They should feel happy about it, that this is the time which is not going to come back also. This is the only time, limited time, and ultimately this will also pass off, and then you will repent. Maybe after 6 months you will repent that I had got such an ample time with myself, but I could not upscale my skills, and what should I do now? I think this is the time that learn languages, learn cooking, learn music, learn painting, and venture into positivity. And that is going to make a difference.
Jaha sir, field colleagues ki sabki wife aapko thank you keh rahi hai.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And actually, hats off to sir, Dr. Praveen Bhatia also, because actually this is said, I think this is the experience which matters, because it's the same thing my wife also, actually, as for my wife, actually, I can only share my wife experience. So during COVID time, actually, she used to sing, and her some talent related to the singing, I came to know only after 20 years of my marriage. So thank you very much, sir.
Thanks. Ultimately, truth prevails.
पर वो जहाँ सा वो गाना तो नहीं गाया ना, जब से हुई है शादी आंसू बहा रही हूँ,
वो गाना तो नहीं गाया ना? उससे भी एक दो और ध्यान आके मैं भेजता हूँ आपको,
ठीक है? अच्छा, वो टैलेंट नहीं पता चलना चाहिए. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन
शास्त्री.
गुड इवनिंग सर एंड गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर. एंड माय क्वेश्चन इज, बीइंग इन फील्ड जॉब, व्हाट आर द मेजर्स शुड वी टेक? वन साइड वी हैव टू एंश्योर द प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड विदाउट कैचिंग एनी इन्फेक्शन. सर,
wonderful. I would again reiterate the same thing. Maintain a social distance. Wear the mask properly, not on the neck, but on the face. Cover your nose. Don't try to touch any time and every time nose or mouth or everyone. Don't try to touch the objects which are lying here, there, and everywhere. And plus, most important thing, which all of us have been doing as surgeons, we have been doing it. But you should also imbibe that into your nature, that use the sanitizer, use your hands, wash them properly every now and then. It should become a habit. I remember my grandmother, Nani Dadi, they would always push us that before entering kitchen, you should wash your hands. Before handling any utensil in the kitchen, please again wash. So our thinking is that let us go back to our traditions and respect those traditions, carry on observing the safe distance, carry on observing the social distance from negativity also, and then use the mask properly. Do not cough it or sneeze on somebody else, and do not handle the objects here and there. that is going to make a difference. Let us let that self-discipline come within us. If that self-discipline comes within us, then obviously Corona will also stay away from us.
Sir, here is one question. Basically, the news was that excessive use of this hand sanitizer can lead to this cancer or psoriasis. Is it correct?
No. Ultimately, all of us know the sanitizer is alcohol.
Right.
And if it is alcohol and if it is being handled in 70% or 30% manner, it is not going to lead on to psoriasis or cancer. No, it is not. But only thing is, I am not saying that you take bath with sanitizer.
You should take alcohol from sanitizer. People sitting here can take alcohol from sanitizer also.
That is not required at this stage. You can get the alcohol at a normal price also. But thinking is that wash your hands. Mask is not a big ask. Mask is not a big ask. You should strongly believe on the mask. You should never be in close contact with the person. That is the responsibility. When Spanish flu was there, that was managed. And now this flu is there. So we should manage and we'll be able to scale through.
Next question, Subodh.
The next question is from Mr. Vinod Singh at Mumbai Edison.
Mr. Vinod.
Yeah. Sir, good evening. So my question is, like, in today's scenario, social isolation is the biggest thing. We are away from friends, relative. How to handle it?
We are away from parents and that is pinching?
Let's social isolation. Ultimately, because of COVID, we are not meeting each other. We are away from friends, relative, everyone. So this is a kind of situation, how to handle it?
You know, my thinking is that as we always discuss, that it has to be social distancing, but not, and one should always believe on distant socializing. Distant socializing means no one will stop you if you call early in the morning or maybe afternoon. What I mean to say that you should definitely talk to each other more often than we would have before, and that will make us positive that if he is doing good, if his family is safe, our family is safe, and that's it. So that kind of positivity ripples should flow. And that will make a difference. This is only a time period. I would not say this is going to last for another 30 odd years. No, it is going to last for maybe 2, 3, 4, 5 months and that's it. So after that, all of us will again meet and hug each other. That's it. So why are we overthinking? We should not overthink. We should definitely take care of the disease per se at the moment and it is going to go away.
Now the next question is from Mr. Milind, our Nagpur Edison.
Yes.
Actually, we are basically a team handling. We are handling a team. We are handling a team of ASM, RSM, and even FSO, SBM. There are a few people who really brings a worst out of you. How really to handle such people?
The negative people.
You need to be like, you know, they are bringing worst out of you. So you have to manage both. You have to manage the entire team and you have to carry best out of, you have to take up best out of these people. So you need to handle entire team.
Good question. Very nice question. But I would put it this way, that feed the people as you are rather than as they are. As you are rather than as they are.
Like you want to be treated.
Exactly. And everyone has got some positivity. Everyone. And if you are able to develop those eyes who see only the positivity, you will be definitely a winner. If you are able to see only the negativity, then this negativity will go and you will imbibe that and you will become negative. So our thinking is, every person God has created with lot of positivity, see that positive attitude only, shun the negativity and you will be definitely making a difference. So treat the people as you are rather than as they are. Let the naysayers remain at the corner. We are moving forward and we should carry on moving forward. They will all automatically change.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Here again, the story from sir's presentation only, you have to be a deaf frog, you know?
Exactly.
That's absolutely.
And even if somebody is criticizing, you should remain positive and take the lead criticism of it and make it a difference.
Right. Thanks, sir. Thank you, sir.
The next question is from Mr. Partha Sati.
Good evening. This is a nice session. I'm enjoying really. My question is that one of my known colleague has got COVID infection. Initially, I was scared. Then how to maintain the calmness so that work is not affected. When known person has get affected, really I got disturbed. So how to maintain a calm and move on forward, sir?
Yes, and the question is that one of your colleagues has developed positivity. And you have to maintain calm so that other people on the team, they should always remain calm. And I think as I started, that it is all about finding the calm in the chaos. And believe me, even I get maybe 50 phone calls every day. Sir, I have turned out to be positive. I say, so what? Even if you are positive, if you are not having any features, if you are not having fever, if you are not having sore throat, if you are not having respiratory distress, stay at home, isolate yourself, remain at quarantine, and you'll be absolutely fine. And plus, only thing is that you carry on observing yourself. If you have temperature maybe after 2-4 days, then also you should take maybe Dolo 650 or Crocin or any of that product, and then ultimately you'll be absolutely fine. So please do not have any panic that you have been tested positive. And if you can convey to them that 95% of us will be having that contraction, the infection, will definitely have the flu-like features, and it will settle down with time, and that's it. Only 5% people, and that too, especially with comorbidities, will suffer, and they have to be very, very careful, and they can be given antiviral and other drugs. But again, the 95% will obviously scan through. So if this kind of thought is given to them, that it will go off, so you will be able to manage your team members very well. And again, the answer to your challenge is that there is no vaccine available. Why are you bothered? If the vaccine was available, I would have done, as a team leader, the effort to get you the vaccine first and then me. But we are not having the vaccine, so let us take the precautions and that's it. So that will spread the positivity. Good.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So there's one more question from Mr. Subit Sen.
Sumita?
Sunai there? Hello?
There.
Hello?
Yes, before my... Go ahead.
Sir, before my question, I would like to say one thing. Corona is a problem for those who are thinking Corona is a problem to them.
Absolutely.
Corona is not at all a problem. Rather, it is an opportunity for those who are thinking that this is the time when I will get less competition and I will come out with life.
Absolutely.
Right.
Very well said. Great.
Honestly, Vikram, I always say that problem is not a proper word. It should be taken as a challenge.
Challenge.
One should never ever say problem. One should say challenge. It is a challenge. It is a challenge for one and all. And it will pass off. As simple as that. One. And then if you go two steps further up, as we mentioned in that story of Arjun and Karna and Yudhishthir, if you start thinking that Corona is God and it has descended to overall the earth, it has descended to make the person introspect that yes, I should not have done this way in my life. Now it is a time to change or upscale my skill set. And now I will function this manner. I should not work like a donkey from 6 a.m. to 12 midnight. But I will make sure that I change my lifestyle so that ultimately I am giving to my family also. I am investing in my health also. That's it. So that is the reason that I always say that the stimulus is same. Coronavirus is same, but your attitude can be different and you can make a difference.
Sir, another fact is that when we were totally in home during that lockdown period, because we are in field for last 2 months, and before that we were in lockdown, and as a result we were doing work at home for around one month. At that time, we saw a lot of media and all these things. Our mindset, some thought has come that what is going to happen. But the moment we went out, I have seen that people like me, a lot of people have working. The environment is coming gradually normal every day. So it gave a different type of motivation or inspiration that if these people can do, and why can't I do? So we gradually, that mindset automatically went off, and we have started our own life. Only the thing is required, we have to take the proper precautions like mask and that hand sanitizer and social, I mean personal distancing. I won't say it is a social distancing. It is person-to-person distancing. These are the 3 things it can be taken care of. At least we can postpone the evil days.
Absolutely.
That is what. And ultimately, herd immunity is the last word, unless an anti-vaccine is required. So there is no question of fear.
True.
Let us be fearless. Let us take precaution. Let us go all in out. Let us achieve.
Absolutely. And believe me, none of us can judge at this moment that maybe after 6 months, I or somebody, if he has got the infection, if he has become positive, he will be proud of it. That I got the infection, I have been able to scale through, and now I am immune forever. So that kind of positivity can also occur. And other people who have not been infected, maybe they will get the infection, because this infection is going to come again and again. So if we are immune, that will be a positive thought. So that kind of, one should always think like it is a challenge, and it is going, and time is the best healer. It is going to prove itself in the long term. Good.
The next question is from Mr. Abhinav Sharma.
Sir, I think we all are fortunate enough to have this beautiful session on the eve of Guru Purnima, sir. And I must compliment you, sir, since in the past 2 hours, sir, your energy level is still maintained, sir. So that is a compliment to you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, my question is this, just during this lockdown, as we see that there are many people who are having fitness enthusiasm. So how a person can keep himself or herself motivated in terms of fitness, and what are the things they can do to make themselves fit? Because most of the gyms, they are closed now. और बहुत सारे जो हेल्थ सलून्स हैं और हेल्थ स्पास हैं, दे आर आल्सो क्लोज नाउ. सो हाउ अ पर्सन कैन हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ फिट ड्यूरिंग दिस कोविड टाइम.
वंडरफुल क्वेश्चन. माय आंसर इज दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम एक्सक्यूसाइटिस. एक्सक्यूसाइटिस मींस दे गिव एक्सक्यूजेस दैट द जिम इज क्लोज्ड और द सलून्स आर क्लोज्ड. दिस इज, दीस आर एक्सक्यूजेस. Our body has such a wonderful way in which we can exercise. For example, I will give you a small tip. There is if you type Leslie Sampson, LeslieSansone, Leslie Sampson, 3-mile walk. She has been teaching how to walk, and walking exercises are there, and she has given the tutorials, or she makes you walk. I do every day for 45 minutes in the evening. And Leslie, my wife and me, even at this age, we do all kind of exercising, the walking exercise, the arms exercise, and this do not need any dumbbells or anything of that sort. But in the morning, for example, from 6 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. till this morning, I have been exercising every day with dumbbells, and dumbbells have been increasing from 2 kg to 5 kg to 7 kg and 10 kg and so on and so forth. So our thinking is that sar jaye par sair na jaye. Body itself is a good muscle. It has the muscle mass. You should concentrate on your muscle mass and then exercise it. Even if, for example, you don't have the terrace garden, even if you don't have the space to work, you should just climb up the stairs, climb down the stairs, climb up the stairs, climb down the stairs. That will be an excellent exercise. So you can find a space, you can do the exercises anywhere, anytime. You don't have to have that excuse that mere paas time hi nahi hai. I think that excusitis has to be kicked off, and then you will be able to make a difference. And plus, you should have a mindset that jaan hai to jahan hai. If you are thinking like that, then you will definitely invest in your health and you will be coming in a positive mode. And with this, scientifically speaking, you will produce more endorphins, and more endorphins will be helpful for your mental health, and that is going to change your path in a positive manner.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you. Thank you.
Sir,
sir,
one of my area manager has given a question.
You can just adjust your so that I can see your mouth, yeah, our face also. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, good. Thank you. Sorry for that.
The question is, sir, with closed schools and no playing, your child's mental health is screaming. How we are going to come out from this situation?
When the children are not going to school.
School. And they are not being able to play. So, some disturbances and they are screaming. So, naturally, how to come out?
Basically, he wants to have tips on the COVID-19 parenting.
Parenting, yes.
For the toddlers.
I would say that they should attend such motivational webinars. Second aspect is that if they are younger, then you can always play with them. I have seen.
Yes.
Play with them and make them, give them riddles. As Vijay Pratap also knows that I have got so many questions and I carry on asking so many questions from the children who come to my OPD. And then they start, for example, from count of 0 to 100, how many nines are there? I would request you all to check it, that from a count from 0 to 100, how many times?
20. Sir, 20.
How many times do you write 9?
20.
20. Anyone 20. Else? Everyone is counting. So let us, what I mean to say, that let them carry on counting and then tell me the answer. The thinking is that there are so many methods to remain positive. There are so many methods in which one can work with your children and let them enjoy your company. Let them draw, let them learn music, let them do some exercises, and that's it. You should not look for the excuses.
Dil to bachcha hai ji.
Let the child within you not die.
Yes, sir.
I think apna bachpana jo hai, bachpan jo hum hamesha kehte the na ki koi lutate mere
bite hue din
bita luta to di, ab uske baad bhi agar tum bhagwan ka shukr na karo to fir to galat hai na.
दिल तो बच्चा है जी,
दिल तो बच्चा है.
सर आपने बताया था ट्रस्ट और बिलीफ.
पार्डन,
सबसे बढ़िया एग्जांपल क्या होगा ट्रस्ट एंड बिलीफ का?
यस, बिटवीन हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ.
नहीं सर, माँ बाप के ऊपर है.
नो, इससे ये सबसे ज्यादा है कि आई हैव ए बिलीफ दैट यू आर माय सन एंड योर मदर हैज द ट्रस्ट.
सर मैं उल्टा बोल रहा हूँ. यू कैन ट्रस्ट योर फादर बट यू मस्ट बिलीव योर मदर.
वी हैव वन मोर क्वेश्चन फॉर मिस्टर लोकेश शर्मा.
क्या लोकेश?
हाय सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर दिस वंडरफुल प्रेजेंटेशन एंड motivating story you have shared with us, and definitely I will share this one of the motivating story with my son also. Okay, sir, my question relate to the medical side. If you see, the person once get infected with the coronavirus, he got the mild symptoms. Okay, he gets over from the corona after 10 days, 15 days, and get the report of the corona negative. So he got the antibodies in the body. Antibodies. Okay, for how long that antibodies lies in the body? If the second wave arises of the corona, is he get infected or he is getting immune for how long?
Very good question, but nobody knows the answer. As I humbly placed it, that it is a novel virus. And you can never ever be certain that what is the path of this virus. Ideally, if somebody was infected with a flu virus, he would become immune throughout life. But in this situation, in China also, they have seen that those people who had been initially infected, who had become positive, and then they became negative, most of the times, they are not becoming positive with the second wave, but there will be some situation they will become. So what I mean to say, at this period of 6 months or 5 months, is too short a period to know the path which this virus is going to take. So we are as illiterate or literate as any one of us are. Even WHO, ICMR, and all those guidelines carry on coming and going off. So I think time is the best healer. Time is going to tell that yes, in the second wave, you will get infected or you will not get
infected. Thank you, sir.
Sir, one question from my side. Sir, this question is from my area manager, Mr. Pankaj. He is saying that while sitting or while coming out or in entering into a chamber, if we touch a corona patient by chance, what will happen? Because, sir, while working, one patient has put his handbag on his bike. So he is scared on that day. That's why he is asking this question.
Absolutely right. Our thinking is that, as I mentioned, that treat the other person as positive until proved otherwise. Treat every person which you are going, whom you are going to meet as a positive until proved otherwise. For example, if he was an asymptomatic carrier, if he was having the viral load within himself and he is not wearing the mask, he is not maintaining the social distance, he is not sanitizing himself properly, he is not hand washing him properly, chances are that he can go gift you the coronavirus. But again, if you are keeping yourself fit, if you are self-disciplined, if you are wearing a mask, if you are having good hygiene, even if you have touched some bag, but if you carry on washing your hand many times, your virus may be gone. So our thinking is, whatsoever other persons may or may not be doing, you should discipline yourself, just like that man throwing the jellyfish inside. Make a difference. You should carry on making a difference in the life of that fish. Means you should carry on following SMS, hand wash, that's it. So if you take all those precautions, the chances are that you will not get infected.
Thank you so
sir,
much.
Sir, I have one more.
Mr. Sir, Ajay Chopra. Mr. Ajay Chopra has one.
Sure. Question from the Subhi, one question is there. Subhi, I have one question. Sir, one of my RBMs, Mr. Sachin Bhatia, he wants to know that as per ICMR, symptomatic patient cannot spread the COVID-19. Sir, is it right, sir?
Symptomatic.
Asymptomatic.
Asymptomatic?
Right, sir.
No, that's what I'm saying. So many guidelines had come. So many guidelines have gone. So many politically driven messages have been there. Our thinking is that anyone and everyone can become a silent spreader. That person who is having a COVID positive test, he definitely has the chance of infecting other person in the first few days, 5 to 7 days. But if you are a silent carrier, it is wrong to say that you cannot make the other person positive. You can always give the viral load to somebody else. Your job, my job, everyone's job is stop the progress. If we stop the progress by taking all the precautions, then the infectivity will go down. So ultimately, you should understand loud and clear that the virus can spread in arithmetic manner or a geometric progression. If it progresses in a geometric progression, that means one person gives the infection to four people, four give to 16, 16 give to 64, and so on and so forth, that is going to make it a community spread. So our thinking is try to cut off that cycle, try to curb that virus to one place, and then it will not spread. So silent spreaders, asymptomatic carriers can also spread the infection. This is a fact that one should be definitely careful about.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ajay Chopra.
Sir, one question is from our field staff that which mask is best for during their working, sir?
Very good question. Answer is that N95 mask, especially you are also healthcare workers, right? So N95 mask is a good best mask at this stage. Whereas if you have only the surgical mask and the obviously the filtration of the virus is not that perfect. I would put it this way. Even if you cover your face, nose and mouth with the cloth, but it is covering it properly, that is a good step. If you are not covering it properly, even if you are wearing N95 mask, but you are wearing on your mouth or you are wearing on your neck, the whole of the purpose is defeated. I would say, go in, buy N95 mask, change it every now and then, and that will give you such elastics also, so that it is fitting nicely onto your nose and to the mouth, and it is closed, then you are absolutely safe. But if you are having N95 mask also, but it is hanging, it is a wrong thing to do. So ultimately, it boils down to not to the quality, but more to the mindset.
So one question.
Some masks are having respirators. So are they also effective?
Yes. Yes, they are effective, definitely. But there is a lot of range. There are channels, there are filters are also available, respirators are also available, thousands and lakhs of filters are also available. But again, for the people of your levels or the people who are working for you, I think tell them to buy the N95 mask and maintain it onto their face nicely. Elastic should be working. It should not be that any time and every time you are touching the outside of the mask. Many times I have seen what people do is that when they start talking, they take the mask down. And I honestly push them. Why are you taking it down? This is the only way that you are going to spread the infection. So please put it on. I am also having the mask in my OPD. Why should you not have it? And then have that culture that you are not going to touch the even the outside surface every now and then with your hand to your eyes to anywhere and everywhere. So thinking is, discipline yourself in such a manner that you are not taking it off, you are not touching every now and then, you are not touching all the organs of the face, then only the corona will go off rather than striking you.
Thank you very much, sir, regarding this.
Sir, here only I would like to ask one question, that there was one news that excessive use of this mask because of this carbon dioxide which is going out is again going back to the lungs. Can it lead to hypoxia?
Yes, good question. Can you imagine when people are doing morning exercise, jogging, and if they are wearing the mask, even if they are walking or running or doing the jogging on the road or in the park alone, and if they are wearing the mask, definitely one exhales carbon dioxide and then one starts inhaling the same carbon dioxide again. And that can lead on to the accumulation of carbon dioxide inside. So for those people, I would always urge that if you are lonely, if you are walking or jogging in the early in the morning, if you don't see anyone around, it is better to take the mask down and then do the jogging. And after that, once you return back, then again put in the mask. You are absolutely right that you should not build up carbon dioxide inside. Good.
One more question from my colleague.
Yeah.
The frequently drinking water will reduce the chances of catching coronavirus. As it goes to the stomach, it will die because of the HCl. Is it true?
If you take the virus, the water...
Water regularly.
Yes. You are right in the sense that if you take water and that to some lukewarm water, I will not say hot water, if you are taking it water frequently, even if it has gone from nasopharyngeal to oropharyngeal space, and if you are taking, then it can go into your stomach, acid will kill it, and that's it. But again, there is a rider. They have studied in New York that even those patients who had a good viral load and who have now even become negative, but still the feces, the stools were examined and they were positive for coronavirus. So thinking is, again, nobody knows.
Nobody knows. Okay.
You should make a point that carry on taking a lot of water. Carry on taking natural food as much as possible. Do not ask the order for the food from outside and then you will be in a better position.
Next question is from my side, Sachin Desai. Sir, I just wanted to know that as we all are aware that in news channel or in newspapers, a couple of companies are coming up or are claiming that the corona vaccine would be out in the market very soon, like Glenmark or Cipla or Bharat Biotech and all. So do you think that will it be possible in next 1 month or 1.5 months time or 3 months?
Good question. Answer is no. It has been, I would say, n number of years that we have not been able to take out the virus for vaccine for HIV. It has been, obviously, I would not be naysayer, I would not be negative in saying, but still, the progress is occurring for making a virus vaccine for coronavirus, but till date, not many trials have been done. I would put it this way, whether it is A, B, or C company, they have to make it absolutely safe that the vaccine should not harm anyone. And because if it has so much of effect that it can kill the virus, it has so much of effect that it can kill the normal cells also. So thinking is that it has to be safe, it has to come out after trials. But again, I could guess, I could judge your question that people have become judgmental that on 15th of August there will be vaccine. I think that is a wrong way of working. You should have enough of trials and you should have enough of effects to be seen. Then only declare that yes, vaccine has come. Similarly, people in UK, the Oxford company and other places, they have announced that yes, vaccine is coming. It has come. Mr. Ramdev has also come. But I don't believe, nobody believes them till it has shown its effects. So our thinking is even if that vaccine is made today, we will not be able to make 8 billion vaccines in a few days or months. It takes time. So our thinking is that let us all pray to God that so much of herd immunity comes to us that ultimately we do not need the vaccine. That's it.
So we are done with all the questions right now. So over to you, Vikram sir.
Thank you.
Sir, at last I would like to thank you. The type of positivity which you have given since 4 o'clock till now, it is almost 6:30, sir, 2.5, and the energy level is still the same. So we have learnt a lot, that too in a very good day, that is Guru Purnima. That is said also that Guru ke bina gyan nahi aur gyan ke bina atma nahi. So you have given lot of gyan today, sir, and definitely we are going to implement. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Vikram. Thank you very much. May
God bless
you all.
Thank you so much, sir.
I must say that you have an excellent. You have an excellent. And your people are doing a very good job. And I am absolutely sure that the bulbs which are behind you, they are going to shine. And you will be able to reach the target of 1,000 crores in a near future and very fast. Because you are positive, because you are innovative, because you are caring for your people, because you are caring for the other people also. Let you remain honest, integrity maintained people. Let those values will be there in your people and you will be able to make a difference. I am very, very thankful to all of you and especially to Vikram, to Vijay, to Suhai, then to everyone who have been able to rope in this kind of exercise so that all of us remain positive in this era. Let us not think of any negativity. We are positive. We will remain positive. Knowledge shared is knowledge gained. I don't think so that if I take the knowledge and I can operate all the patients. I cannot operate everyone on earth. So if I have some knowledge, if I am able to share, obviously my knowledge also goes up. That is the philosophy which we work on. Again, with the core of my heart, I thank one and all, and Mr. and Mrs. Parliya Mother also, everyone. God bless them. And you have an excellent team. Carry on. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you to all our panelists and the audience. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.